Hi, Snowflake. Did you know you can now support me by becoming a channel member for less than $1 per month by clicking the join button right at the top of my page? You will have access to different perks like priority reply to comments, badges next to your username, custom emojis, a monthly members-only sleep aid video, sneak peeks of future content, and voting power on the next Stardust video. All my members-only videos appear at the top of my channel page right here. There's also a dedicated playlist for Stardust members, so it's nice and easy to find the content you're paying for. Thank you so much to everyone who's joined already, and if you haven't, I hope to see you there soon.
Hey, it's me. Open up.
Sheesh, finally. Hey, can you help me? If they'd told me sooner, I wouldn't have started unpacking in the other room. I had all my stuff sorted neatly into my suitcase, and now it's all in a mess. Here, can you take this? What do you mean, what am I doing? Didn't Brian tell you? Okay, so you were supposed to room with Brian, and I was supposed to room with Emily, right? But, well, the two of them are dating, you know? And so they wanted to share a room so they could make out or whatever. And that's why Emily asked me if we could switch roomies, and I said yes, because I'm just too nice. And Brian was supposed to tell you and ask you whether this was okay for you, but from your surprised face, I take it that he didn't. So I'll do it now. Are you okay with this? Oh, come on, party pooper. This is gonna be their first big trip together as a couple. What? Yeah, we're not technically allowed co-ed rooming, but come on. As long as you don't tattle on us, Mr. Abercrombie will never find out. For real now, chicken shit? You're a straight-A student and the resident teacher's pet. What is the worst they will do to you? Not let you come along to the Vatican Museum tomorrow? Oh, you were really looking forward to that. Well, to each their own, I guess. Okay, if Mr. Abercrombie finds out, you can simply tell him that Emily and I forced you into it. Nobody who knows you would ever doubt that story. Hey, what do you mean we kinda are? I'm sorry, I didn't think having to share a room with me would be such a tribulation. For real now, you've been tutoring me in Latin for how long now? Like, a year or something? You've been tutoring me essentially since I started taking Latin. You've been to my room a whole bunch of times already, and sat on my bed, and used my bathroom and everything. And I've been to your room and laughed about your stupid posters and your action figures. Oh, I'm sorry, your collectible anime figures. So I really think you'll survive sharing a room with me for 1 week. I promise not to make fun of you more than absolutely necessary. So then, now that we have this settled, which bed is mine? Oh, can I have the one by the window? Nice. Hey, why are you staring at me like that? Huh? No, this is not a prank. Wow, why do you always assume the worst about me? Okay, yeah, don't answer that. I probably deserve whatever bad opinion you have of me. But still, we spent so much time together this past year. I believed we became at least somewhat like friends. Plus, do you really assume I would carry all my stuff over here and cram it into these drawers for one lame joke just to then carry it all back to my own room? You completely overestimate the amount of effort I'd be willing to make just for you. Hey, speaking of my stuff, can you help me unpack? Oh, you're a darling. Here. Just put this stuff into the wardrobe so I can go find an outlet and my socket adapter. My phone is about to die. And you know how I get when I can't have my phone. What's going on? Why are you blushing? No, you look weird. You're acting weird. What's going on? Oh, just put that into the drawer with all my other stuff. Oh, come on. It's just underwear. You like it? It's cute, isn't it? What? Did you expect me to wear long johns? Now that we're rooming together, maybe you'll even get a peek of me wearing them. Oh, come on, don't be such a prude. I know I certainly won't be when I catch a glimpse of you in your undies. Oh, for real now, you cannot seriously expect me to stop teasing you when you keep making that adorable face every time I do. How could I possibly resist the temptation? Hey, come on now, you know me. I'm gonna be an exemplary roommate. I won't snore. I won't steal your snacks. I won't listen to loud music in the middle of the night. And I won't let my dirty socks lie around in the open. We'll have a lot of fun together over the next week. Trust me. I mean, we always had fun during our tutoring sessions, didn't we? What? No, I didn't bully you. It's not my fault you can't take a joke. Are you done with my stuff? Excellent. Thank you. Alright, we still have a couple of hours until dinner, so what shall we do with the rest of the day? Really? Oh my god. Dude, you are not studying right now, are you? Come on, you already must be straight A. What are you trying to go for? Even straighter A's? I mean, hey, you made me pass Latin. That alone is essentially a Nobel Prize level achievement right there, because I suck at Latin. I never really got the knack of it. Like, hic, haec, hoc, huius, huius, huius.
And why did they not have words for yes and no?
I mean, what did they moan while...
never mind. Frankly, I never really saw the point of learning a language that nobody speaks anymore. I mean, why couldn't we learn, like, Italian? Then at least we could talk to the people living here.
What am I ever gonna use Latin for? I guess it would come in handy if I ran into a gladiator or a legionary, but except for that. Sorry? Why did I... because it sounded fun at the time. I mean, Latin, you know, it's kind of posh and everything, right? And it probably looks good in your resume. So, makes potential future employers think you're smart and stuff. Yeah, I know I suck at it. Thanks for reminding me, jerk. I can't help it. I mean, I try, but I'm constantly worried that if I mispronounce something, I might accidentally summon a demon or something. No, really, isn't there this wizard in Harry Potter that mispronounced a spell and suddenly ended up on the floor with a buffalo on his chest? Oh, his name's Barufio. Nerd. Okay, so back to my original question. What do you want to do with the rest of our day? I mean, starting tomorrow, Mr. Abercrombie will probably have our days stuffed with all kinds of terribly educational stuff. Like we're going to the Vatican Museum tomorrow, and I believe St. Peter's. And then after that, like the Forum and the Colosseum and whatnot. I mean, he's got our week packed. So if we want to get a whiff of the real Rome, you know, explore the neighborhood and have some ice cream somewhere. Or maybe even a glass of wine. If you'd have the guts to come out of your shell for once and be less of a wimp, then this is probably our only chance. Oh, come on. You don't need to repeat your vocab.
Are you for real? Dude, we're in Rome. We should do as the Romans do. And I'm pretty sure the Romans are making out. Come on, I'm bored. I want to do something. And I never got to properly thank you for tutoring me all this time. What? No, I have to. You got me to pass Latin. That's a miracle. I imagine that can't have been an easy task. Okay, wow. Little hint here. When a girl says something like that, she expects you to disagree. I don't care whether it's true or not. We still expect you to disagree. Okay, so anyways, I want to thank you for investing so much time and effort into me over the past year. And I thought, you taught me so much, maybe I can teach you something in return. Oh, well, something that I am good at. Like, for example, have you ever kissed anyone? Hey, what's with that face? You haven't. Am I right? Come on, it's fine to admit it. There's no shame in that. I mean, that's what I'm here for, right? Okay, it's settled then. After all, kissing doesn't simply work by itself. It's an art and a science that needs to be studied and practiced. And I'll expect you to put the same diligence and persistence into this as into repeating your vocab. What? Oh, the heck, you were planning on checking out the neighborhood. You stay right here, buddy. How else will you ever learn? Okay, come and sit next to me. You're taller than me. Maybe I should sit on your lap. Yeah, that's better. This way, we're on perfect kissing level. Plus, you can't get away from me anymore. For real now. Just imagine I had tried to run away during your tutoring lessons. Yeah, but that was only once. Okay then. Kissing 101, first lesson. So, first of all, to be always ready for the eventuality of kissing, you want to keep your lips appealing. That is, you'll want them to always be nice and soft. So you should use chapstick or lip balm every day. Here. See? You just take a bit and gently massage it onto your lips. See? Like this. Oh, whoopsie. I took a bit too much. Here. Do you need some? Yeah, this stuff was already on my lips. So what? Okay, are you for real right now? You are aware that we're about to practice kissing, right? How do you propose to do that if you can't even handle me giving you a bit of my lip balm? So stop making a fuss already. You are. If this is you not making a fuss, then maybe I'll have to restrain you before the next step in case you do start fussing. Oh, and how am I supposed to put lip balm on you without touching your lips? God, and everybody thinks you're a genius or something. Okay, so the most important thing when trying to initiate a kiss is consent. Never just brutishly force yourself into a partner, okay? Huh? Were you trying to say something? Yeah, I didn't think so. So, if the other person doesn't initiate the kiss, just ask for permission. in case you don't want to plainly ask for it because you think that isn't romantic or anything, which you shouldn't, because a lot of people actually find it really sweet when their partner asks them before kissing them, especially the first time. But if you don't want to simply ask, you can test the waters by trying something small, like a kiss on their hand. Hello? Hey, did you fall asleep on me or something? I said try something like kissing her on the hand. What do you think we're doing here, huh? I'm giving it my best to try and teach you something. Don't you think you could put in at least a bare minimum of effort? Gosh, you are worse at this than I am at Latin. Gee, finally. Okay. Then, let's go for the main event. When kissing someone proper, it is crucial for you to be able to read their signals. Are they reciprocating the kiss? Are they relaxed? Are they leaning into it? Learn some body language. You, for example, are leaning away from me. Hey, stop that. What's your problem? Get back here. Yes, I said consent is the most important thing, but you've already given me your consent. Do you want to take it back? Do you want me to get off of you right now? Do you? That's what I thought. Okay, let's go on. First of all, you don't want to give me any weird granny kisses, okay? So do not pucker your lips. That is just creepy. Keep your lips slightly parted. Relax. Relax. Hello? I said relax. Why are you not relaxing? You are hopeless. Maybe we should have given you a glass of wine before starting this, huh? Hey, if I had had a glass of wine before each of your lessons, maybe they would have been more fun. Alright, let's move on with the lesson. Okay, so as I see it, kissing is a bit like baking. Of course, you're looking forward to the cake at the end, but the way to get there is fun and rewarding in itself. Shut up, I'm awesome at metaphors. Stop giving me lip. Just stop. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is, you wouldn't want to just barge in and go straight for the full-on, no-holds-barred French kissing stuff. I mean, you can do that in the heat of the moment, when both your partner and you are really into it and you don't want to waste any more time. But if you do that every time, you'll miss out on a lot of fun stuff on the way. So, again, you might want to start small, with something like kissing with just lips, you know? Something sweet and light and tender. Something like this. Hey, don't let me do all the work. You're being so lazy right now. You know how weird it feels when you kiss someone and they're not moving and they're just frozen in shock like a deer on the highway? If you really want me to teach you, you have to work with me here. Well, you might want to try something like nibbling on your partner's lower lip. The magic word being gently. Okay, so I'll try again. And this time I expect a bit more effort from you. Let's go for it. One, two. Yeah, that's better. I'm quite proud of myself. I must be a damn good teacher, apparently. Okay, rule number two. A kiss is not just about your tongue and lips. For example, where do you put your hands? Hey, this was not a rhetorical question, dummy. I'm waiting for an answer. Think of this as your midterm exam. Well, to spoon feed you every little bit of this. You could, for example, put your hands on my hips. Oh, wow. Okay, calm down. Don't get a heart attack. You don't have to, okay? You could also just put them on my lower back. Or you could play with my hair. Come on, you're a smart cookie. Get creative. Oh, see? This is nice. A bit clumsy, still. Maybe. But not bad for a beginner. We can work with that. I think we're ready for the next lesson. Tongue. What? Don't give me that. Do you want to learn this or not? You know what? Don't answer. It doesn't matter. Nobody asked me whether I wanted to learn trigonometry or arithmetic or stuff. One day, you need to learn how to kiss properly, and today is as good a day as any, and I happen to be your roommate right now, so it would seem I gotta be the one teaching you. Hey, it could have been worse. Be glad you're not rooming with Brian anymore. What? Hold it together, nerd. Of course you can do this. Amanti nihil difficile. To the lover, nothing is difficult. Yeah. Really, you've been tutoring me for a year now. I mean, I had to pick up a few bits at least, right? Okay then, buddy. French kissing for dummies. So, when it comes to tongue, less is more. You want to caress your partner's tongue, not their uvula. Start with just the tip of the tongue. Carefully probe your partner's mouth and see how they react. Oh, and don't forget to swallow every now and then. I tell you, nothing's as aggressively unsexy as someone slobberily salivating all over your face. Alright then, are you ready? Open your mouth. Hey, open up. Are you for real right now? I am your teacher, dammit. Don't get me to make you stay after class and write lines. I will open my mouth when my teacher tells me to. Hey, will you? Alright, but don't you dare complain. You brought this on yourself, buddy. Yeah, I bit you. That's what you get for being such an unruly student. I can't have you slow down my class. Oh, come on, stop whining. It was just a small bite. Remember, ubi amor, ibi dolor. Where there's love, there's pain. Anyway, stop disrupting class. We're in the middle of a very important lesson here. All of this will be covered in the exam, so you better pay attention. So, as I said, when it comes to tongue kissing, you start slow. Just carefully caressing the tip of my tongue with yours. And then you gradually increase intensity. Okay, are you ready this time? Fine then. Show me what you got. Wow, that was unexpected. You sure you haven't done this before? Darling, you're a natural. We could turn you into a pro. You'll need a lot more practice for that, of course. So I suggest from now on, we use every spare minute working on your kissing skills. It really is a shame we'll have to spend most of the week visiting some boring churches and museums and stuff, but hey, luckily we're sharing a room, so we'll have all night to practice. Yeah, we have to. don't look so shocked. Don't think you can just slack off because you've got some talent in you. Much to learn, you still have, my young Padawan. For example, a good kisser should not just be an expert at kissing the mouth. There are other disciplines you need to master. Like, for example, kissing the ears. Or the neck. Or the collarbone. Do you really want me to stop? I've wanted to do this for more than a freaking year. I don't want to stop. Yeah, Sully. Why did you think I enrolled in Latin? Do I, in any way, shape, or form, give the impression that I'm an enthusiast for dead languages that nobody, except for the Pope and Mr. Abercrombie, speaks anymore? I'm not, okay? I'm enthusiastic for you. So I thought, if I had you tutor me, then we would spend a whole lot more time together. And then maybe one thing would lead to another. You know? Intret amicitiae nomine dectus amor. May love enter cloaked in the name of friendship. Huh? Yeah, that's from The Art of Love. Don't look so surprised. If anything, I should be surprised that you know that. Why are you reading stuff like that, you little perv? Hey, don't answer my question with another question. Yeah, I've wanted to do this for more than a year. What do you mean, why? Come on, dummy. I've talked Emily into swapping roommates. I'm sitting on your lap. What else am I supposed to do for you to finally get it? Man, first trade A student, you are annoyingly slow. I'm in love with you, stupid. Do I have to spell it out for you? L-O-V-E. Love. Excuse me? I am so in love with you. I learned a freaking language just to spend some time with you. I must be completely crazy, but amantes amantes, I guess. Lovers are madmen. What do you mean, why? Stop putting yourself down, dummy. You are sweet and smart and funny, and your eyes are... Oh my gosh, don't get me started on your eyes. And you kept tutoring me for the entire year, even though I must have been the most annoying, most hopeless student ever. Wait, what? What do you mean? You just kept tutoring me because... You mean you... Okay, are you kidding me right now? Are you trying to tell me that you had a crush on me for the entire year? And that's why you kept on tutoring me? And you are telling me now? Okay, for this alone, I should bite you again. I mean, you're telling me that we could have been making out for an entire year and instead we were learning hick, hick, hawk? Okay, you better kiss me right now. You gotta keep my mouth occupied or I swear I will bite you. Hey, it's true. Amor magister est optimus. Love is the best teacher. You have become a kissing prodigy in record time. Oh, don't you get too cocky, nerd. Class is not over. There are still some other things I can teach you. So, where were we? Oh, yeah, right. Your collarbone.